क्लास थ्री मैथमेटिक्स। हेलो डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न चैप्टर फाइव, टाइम। डू यू नो हाउ टू रीड द टाइम फ्रॉम ए क्लॉक? टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट एनालॉग क्लॉक। एज यू कैन सी ऑन द पिक्चर, ए क्लॉक हैज थ्री हैंड्स। वन थिन एंड fast moving hand is called a second hand. This moves in each second. Next bigger hand is the minute hand. This shows minute. The short hand is the hour hand. It shows hours. You can see the face of the clock is marked with numerals 1 to 12. This shows 1 to 12 hours of the day. Did you notice small markings on the clock? There are 60 such markings. Each mark shows 1 minute. Minute hand take 1 minute to move from one marking to the next. Can you say how many minutes the minute hand will take to move from one number to the next? Yes, it takes 5 minutes to move from one number to the very next number. So if the minute hand is at number one, that means it passed 5 minutes. It will take 10 minutes to reach number two. For reaching number 3, minute hand needs 15 minutes. If the minute hand is at 12, it shows the hour of the day. Can you say what is the time showing on this clock? Here, the minute hand is at 12, that means 0 minutes. Now we have to look at the hour hand. Here, the hour hand is at 3. So the time is 3 o'clock. The hour hand take 1 hour to move from one number to the next. In this time, the minute hand will complete one rotation. So we can say that 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So the when the minute hand completing one rotation, it will take 60 minutes. That is 1 hour. Now let us learn the movement of minute hand in an hour. The above pictures shows the movement of minute hand. On the first picture, both the minute hand and the hour hand is at number 12. Minute hand is at 12, shows 0 minutes. And the hour hand is at 12, shows 12 hours. So, this we can say that 12 o'clock. And the next picture shows the hour hand is at 12 and the minute hand is at 1. For reaching number 1, the minute hand passed 5 small markings. That means it passed 5 minutes. So the time is 12 hours 5 minutes. This we will say that, say as 5 minutes past 12. In the third picture, the minute hand is at 2. That means the minute hand passed 10 small markings to reach at 2. So, how many minutes passed by the minute hand there? Yes, the minute hand passed 10 minutes and the hour hand is at 12. So the time is 12:10. Or we can say that 10 minutes past 12. The third picture, sorry, the fourth picture, the minute hand is at 3. So it covered 15 small markings. Then we can say the time is 12:15 or 12 minutes past 12. Sorry, 15 minutes past 12. Or we can say that 12:15. Then in the next picture, the minute hand is at 4. So how many small markings it covered? Yes, there are 20 small markings the minute hand covered. So the time is 12:20 or 20 minutes past 12. Here from this 5 pictures, you can find that when the minute hand is at 1, how many minutes is passed? 5 minutes is in. So that is 1 multiplied by 5 is 5, right? And the minute hand is at 2, what is the minute there? 10 minutes, isn't it? So 2 multiplied by 5 is also 10, right? And in the third case, sorry, in the fourth one, when the minute hand is at 3, that shows 15 minutes. 3 multiplied by 5 is also equal to 15, isn't it? So for finding minutes, you just have to multiply the number with 5. If the minute hand is at 6, you just for 6, then the minute will be 6 multiplied by 5. 6 5s are 13. So if the minute hand is at 6, that means 30 minutes. Okay, we can go to the next picture, the sixth one. In this, the hour hand is at 12 and the minute hand is at 5. So again 5 more minutes it took, and now we can find the minute. We just have to multiply 5 by 5. So 5 multiplied by 5 is equal to 25. So the time is 12:25 or 25 minutes past 12. Here in the first picture, the minute hand is at 6. That shows 30 minutes. Why we are saying it as 30 minutes? Because we just have to multiply 6 by 5, you will get 6 5s are 30. So you can write the time 12:30. You could say it as 30 minutes past 12 or 12:30. In the second picture, the minute hand is at 7 and this shows 7 5s are 35 minutes. So the time is 12:35. Or we can say it has 25 minutes to 1. Why we are saying it has 25 minutes to 1? Because there are 25 more minutes to reach 1 o'clock. Now in the third picture, the minute hand is at 8. So how many minutes are there? Yes, 8 5s are 40 minutes. And the time is 12:40. So we could say it has 20 minutes to 1 because there are 20 more minutes to reach at 1 o'clock. Now in the fourth picture, the minute hand is at 9, so the time will be 9:45. And there are 15 more minutes to reach at 1 o'clock, so we can say it has 15 minutes to 1, or we can say it has 1:15. Then after moving 5 more minutes, the minute hand will reach at 10. So 45, then adding 5 more minutes to 45, it will reach 45 plus 5 50. So the time is 12:50, or we can say that 10 minutes to 1 because there is 10 more minutes remaining to reach 1 o'clock. And in the last picture shows the minute hand at 11. That means 5 more minutes from 50 minutes. So 50 plus 5 55, or you just have to multiply 11 into 5. 11 5s are 55. That way also we will get 55. So the time is 12:55, and you can say it has 5 minutes to 1. Now let's do some examples. Write the time shown by following clocks. Here the hour hand is at 7, so 7 hours, and the minute hand is at 12, that shows 0 minutes, so the time is 7:00, or we can call it as 7 o'clock. In the second picture, the minute hand is at 12, that shows 0 minutes, and the hour hand is at 4, that shows 4 hours, so the time is 4:00, or we can call it as 4 o'clock. Write the time shown by the following clocks. Here in the first picture, the hour hand is at 4, that shows 4 hours, and the minute hand is at 2. This means 10 minutes. You just have to multiply 2 by 5. 2 5s are 10. So the time is 4:10, or 10 minutes, minute past 4. Now we can go to the second picture of clock. In this, the minute hand shows minute hand is at 10. That means you just have to multiply 10 by 5. 10 5s are 50. So 50 minutes. And what is the position of the hour hand? Is it on 2 or 1? Here you have to take 1 because it is not at reached at 2. The hour hand is in between 1 and 2. So we can take in hour, we have to take 1 hour. 1 as hour. So the time is 1:50, or we can say it as 10 minutes to 2. In each day, the 12 hours clock shows the same time 2 times. We know that there is 6 o'clock in the morning and 6 o'clock in the evening. When we are saying about the time in the morning, we represent it with two alphabets, AM. The full form of AM is antemeridian. The hours from 12 midnight to 12 noon is called AM. Morning 6 o'clock is written as 6 a.m. And 12 midnight is also written as 12 a.m. From 12 noon to 11 midnight is denoted by p.m. Full form of p.m. is post meridian. 12 o'clock at noon is written as 12 p.m. Evening 6 o'clock is also written as 6 p.m. Calendar. A calendar shows the year, month, and date of a particular day. 1 year comprises 12 months. In a year, there are 365 days. In 1 month, there are 30 to 31 days, except February. February has only 28 days. In 1 week, there are 7 days. Sunday to Saturday, there are 7 days. In 1 day, it's divided as 24 hours. Again, 1 hour is divided into 60 minutes. February has 29 days in leap year. A leap year comes in every 4 years. So after completing 3 years, the next 4th year is a leap year. Now let's do some examples to convert units. First one, convert 3 years into months. We know that in 1 year there are 12 months. So in 3 years, we have to multiply 12 by 3. So we got our answer, 36 months. Second question, convert 2 years into days. In 1 year, there are 365 days. So in 3 years, sorry, in 2 years, 365 multiplied by 2 days, which is equal to 730 days. Question number 3, convert 6 months into days. We know that in a month there are 30 to 31 days. Here we are taking the number of days are 30. So in 6 months, the number of days is equal to 30 multiplied by 6. That is equal to 180 days. The fourth example, convert 8 weeks into days. We know that in 1 week there are 7 days. In 8 weeks, there are 7 multiplied by 8 days. So we know that 7 8s are 56. So in 8 weeks, there are 56 days. Now let's learn how to find a particular date from a calendar. Here the picture shows the calendar of July 2020. Now we are going to find 4th July 2020. Here 4 is the day, 7 is the month, and 2020 is the year. Here the July is the 7th month. So the 7 represent July month. Now we could mark 4th July 2020 on the calendar. Yes, now you can see that it falls in a Saturday. So we can say that 4th July 2020 is a Saturday. Can you find which day is 26th July 2020? So when you are checking, 26th is a Sunday. So in this way, we can find dates on a calendar. Dear children, now our chapter is over here. All of you do the textbook exercises. Thank you all. Bye.